No matter what to him, so when I come around people, I can be present and loving. Because I had someone years ago to tell me that I never looked like I was in pain, and I told them, what did that supposed to look like? I didn't know. And they said, well, you're always present. My mother told me years ago, just because you're miserable, you don't mean to make nobody else miserable. So I carry that with me to know that when I'm not feeling my best, I don't have to push that on you. I need to be loving. And when I'm not feeling like this, sometimes when I get out of myself, it takes me out of what I'm dealing with. And I'm showing love to somebody else. It's a love thing, y'all.
Yeah.
Love is a choice.
Yes.
You must be intentional about love.
Yes. That's right. That's
right.
We shall clothe ourselves in the garment of love. Galatians 3:14, the message states, and regardless of what you put on, wear love.
Yeah.
It is your basic all-purpose garment. Never be without it. It's a love thing. I don't care how pretty you look, how much jewelry you got on, if you ain't got love on. It's just like 1 Corinthians 13 said. You can prophesy, you can be anointed, but if you ain't operating in love, you just a noisy temple. So every day, I know we put on the full armor of God, but don't forget to put on love. Dress yourself up in love. Because it's not about you. It's about somebody else. And when I realized how much God really loved me, I think it was really in 2020. Well, now, when we were doing the pandemic, and we were home, and God spoke to me, and he said, do you really realize how much I love you? Because some days I didn't love myself. And when I started thinking about the love of God and what he did for me and what he do for me every day, who am I not to love somebody else? Who am I not to share that love with somebody else? No, I may not love you the way God loved you, because his love is unlimited. His love is deep. It's wide. We can't even comprehend his love. But it blows my mind for a share that love with somebody else. It's a love thing, y'all. I demand you to love each other as much as I love you, according to John 15, 12, and that's the Living Bible. Demand means to ask or call for with authority, to ask for something forcefully in a way that shows you that you do not expect to be refused. submitted to him, all of that needs to start changing.
Yeah.
It, I don't want to say, it unravels me. That's a good word, thank you. When people say, well, that's just the way she is. But she's a child of God. And no, it doesn't matter how long you've been saved, but when you are sitting up under the word, when you are sitting up under the anointing of God, something about you got to change. If it's not, then you need to check yourself before you wreck yourself, because you are just sitting in vain. And when that epiphany hit me, it was years ago, I had to tell my husband, you have to move aside because Jesus done took your place, baby. Now, I love my husband to life, but I love God even the more. Because I realized if I didn't love God the way God wanted me to love him and put him first, I could not love my husband the way I'm supposed to. I could not be a submissive wife and a loving wife to him. So I had to put God, and Pastor preached some time ago about putting, setting your priorities. And that was when I really put God first, above everything. Because if I don't put him first, nothing else matters. Nothing else matters. Nothing is going to fall into place because he's out of place. And when we put him in place, the love will fall. Songwriter said, love come down. Ooh, you made my love come down. See, when we put God in first, that love gonna come down on you. That love gonna come down on you, baby. I just bless God for just loving me. Love is something you cannot hold on to, y'all. You gotta give it away. You gotta give it away. What good is having love and you ain't giving it to nobody?
Amen.
What does it benefit you? Huh? You're just sitting in love. And ain't nobody experiencing what you got because you're just sitting on love. Give it away freely. Because it ain't going to hurt you. And if people don't accept your love, girl, keep it moving. Like Pastor say, grace and peace, I'm going to keep on moving. But know you're doing the commandments of the Lord by loving them. And I used to, people say you love hard, because I used to say that. Now I'm trying to figure out, what does that mean, love hard? And my husband, he used to tell me, he said, Alice, everybody's not going to love the way you love, so you have to accept the way they love you. That was a hard lesson for me to learn, because when I love you, I love you. When I'm faithful and loyal to you, I'm in. I'm all in. I don't half step when it comes to my people. I mean, whether you're my friends, my sister in Christ, if I say I love you, I love you. And then I used to get hurt because I wasn't getting that same love back. And my husband said, Alice, they love you the best way they can. So that has been a journey for me to accept the way people love me, to meet them where they are, because everybody don't love the same. And it doesn't mean that they don't love you any more, any less than you love them. You just got to be receptive of that love, receive it, and then give the way you love, you just keep loving the way you love. Because I told the Lord, I don't ever want to stop loving the way I love. I really don't. I go all in. And sometimes I do get hurt, but I'm angry and I take my broken heart to the Lord and I let him live. That's what I do. So, and I'm standing there and walking, and I felt like a pull come out of my chest. And in the spirit, God showed me my heart. And I said, what is this? He said, that's your heart. It was spotted. It was black. He said, that's unforgiveness. He said, but I'm going to put a new heart in you. And when I give you this new heart, you're going to be free to forgive quickly. And I kid you not, when I came to, apostle people were standing over me, helping me up. Nobody in the room but me and Jesus. And from that day on, I forgive quickly. And I love, because I don't want God to judge me for my love walk. That's one thing I don't want him to judge me. I know I'm going to stand in judgment for some most things. Bless your name, God. But the love walk, I'm going to try to get that right. See, the Bible says there is nothing stronger than love, not even death, according to the Songs of Solomon, chapter 8, verse 6 through 7. It says it burns like a blazing fire. Many waters cannot quench love. Rivers cannot sweep it away. That's a strong something, y'all. Even Romans 8 says nothing can separate you from the love of God. Not even death, not even life, not even principality. So, if we cannot be separated from that, why aren't we loving? Why aren't we loving? We need to love God. And I don't know who rewrote Stephanie Mills' song. Somebody rewrote it as a gospel song now. And when I first heard it, I'm like, that's Stephanie Mills' song. And I looked it up, and it is. But the words, some of her words are so enlightening, because she said, I never knew love like this before. Mm-hmm. Now I'm lonely no more. Since you came into my life, you are my love light. Yeah. How about that? I like that. She said, this I know, and I never let you go. You are my all. You are part of me. Once I was lost, but now I'm found. You have turned my world around. See, that's what the love of God will do for you. It'll turn your world around. And then she And then when they pierced you in your side, they nailed you, they put a crown of thorns on your head, you didn't say nothing. You could have called a legion of angels down, but just took it because it was a love thing. Even the devil thought he was winning, but it was a love thing, and you, and he was being defeated. For loving us. Some of us, God never experienced that love. You loved us. The Bible says when we were yet still sinners, you died for us. That's love. That's love. So God, pray and ask that if there's anyone here who do not know the love of God, the love of God, the real love of God, come to the altar. He's pouring it out. He's pouring it out. He never stops pouring. It's a continual flow. The love of God. It's a continual flow. It heals you inside out. His love strengthens you. His love carries you. So we thank you for your love, Daddy. We thank you for your love, Daddy. We thank you for allowing us to sit on your lap and love on us, your daughters and your sons, Daddy. And Daddy, we don't ever want to take that love for granted. Oh, Daddy, we want to share your love freely because you so freely give it to us. We always say much is given, much is required to other things, but much is given and much is required of the love. So we bless you on tonight, God. We glorify you. We magnify you. And we exalt you, God. And I pray, God, if they don't hear anything else, I pray that they will clothe themselves in love. The all-purpose garment. It's the garment that you can wear winter, spring, summer, or fall. The all-purpose garment. It will cover you. It will protect you. It will lead you and it will guide you. So we give you honor and we give you praise. And it is in the matchless name of the love, the lover of my soul, Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
You're blessed by today's message and have decided to accept Jesus Christ as your Savior, or you want to be reconciled in your relationship with the Lord, please feel free to contact us by either sending a message through Facebook or going to our website, firstwalltown.org. You will find contact information on the link in the upper right-hand corner. Be blessed.